Newfoundland, one of Canada's greatest treasures. From sea to sky in one easy breath. Coastline to rocky hills in a blink of an eye. Located just off the Trans-Canada Highway as you head down the Buren Peninsula is a place like no other on Earth. It's a drive nobody should go without doing, simply for the fantastic scenery. Swift Current is one of those treasures. But if history, beautiful scenery, and driving are all the things you enjoy, then you'll have to take in Vernon's Antique Toy Shop, a hidden diamond amongst the gold coins. Witness the past, the fast, and the present.
My first car was a 1967 Plymouth Belvedere. That happened in 1984. And 7 years lapsed before I bought my next car, which was a 60 Thunderbird, which actually it ended up on the cover of Paul McCartney's latest album, Driving Rain. And from 1990 to 95, again, a lapse in collecting. When I bought my 53 Buick Skylark, that's right behind us here now as part of the Golden Triangle, meaning the 53 Eldorado, the Cadillac, and the Fiesta. Very limited, but desirable cars. And from 95 until now, I guess things really picked up speed. The oldest car here is a 1908 Buick, and the newest is 1970. Predominantly all convertibles. The criteria is limited production, outstanding in engineering design, and very unique. We have one of 18 of the GTO judges here. We have one of the Pontiac Bonneville with fuel injection. It even has a sportable radio as an option. We have a 57 Mercury Turnpike Cruiser here, the official Indy pace car, that has a five-position electric memory seat. A couple of pickup trucks as well. The top-of-the-line 57 Chevy Cameo pickup with a fiberglass box. We have a 57 Dodge pickup here, which has the swept side. Very limited production. They made 1,050 of them. The 55 Chrysler New Yorkers here. The Thunderbird family, V12 Cadillacs. We have 29 and a 31 Cadillac here. 40 Packard Darren. I have a 55 Mercury and a 56 here, as well as a Lincoln that has automatic chassis lubrication system. When the front end needed to be oiled, there was a light that came on the dash. It's a can of oil with vacuum in front of it, and the lines all went to the necessary components on the front end. I broke the rule once here. I have a 1970 Hemi Cuda here that was built in a convertible. However, they only made 14 of them, and yes, I did have an opportunity to buy one. However, the difference in the price of a Hemi Cuda today in a hardtop versus a convertible is a cool $2.5 million. So that's pretty well sums up why I don't have one. The one that I have here is extremely rare. They made 284 only. It is loaded to the hill with every exclusive option. So from 1908 to 1970, they're pretty well all represented. There are four or five cars here that are not convertible, however, are very unique and very desirable.